It's your girl, Abba Lovin' It, back with another big Ayo. Before I start this video, I want to greet everyone a belated Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. So here's your late gift. Background is not really clean, and you don't have to focus on that because you have to focus on me because this is my vlog. What matters the most is I'm here and alive and kicking, back at it again with another sit down stand up video. A lot of you guys have been requesting what do you normally do during long haul flights. Fear not, baby girls and baby boys, because for today's vlog I'm granting your wish. I'm like a genie, you know, I'm a genie in a bottle, baby. The thing I like about vlogging is that I don't normally have to dress up. All the rest doesn't really matter. Walang ligo and all. I'm just kidding. Siyempre naligo ako kahapon. Without further ado, let's get to it. Tip number one, go for an aisle seat. Now, I usually go for an aisle seat, but if I'm lucky enough and the airline does not charge me for an exit row, you gotta grab that chance. The only downside about this is that in case of a real emergency happens, you have no choice but to say, yes, you're willing to do it, even if you have no idea what to do. Am I right? Or am I right? Usually, big airlines does not charge you to be seated in exit row. Me, unfortunately, last month, I had to pay $20 to be seated in an exit row area. But, can I just say, it is the best investment ever. I can probably sleep, do some push-ups, exercise, baby freeze, whatever you want. You can do it with all those space. It's like your ex. He asked for some space. Yes, you have to pay for the space. After that, you didn't see each other again. And because I love you guys, I will show you this clip from my exit row experience. Tip number two. Always hydrate yourself. For those people who haven't experienced traveling by a plane, you can bring any liquids more than 50 ml. So I suggest to bring water bottles with you. Inside the airport, you can refill your water bottle with mineral water for free. If you buy a water bottle inside, it will cost like twice as expensive. So nobody likes expensive stuff. It's water, it should be free. Am I right? Usually the air inside the aircraft is so dry, you get easily dehydrated. You feel nauseated, feel like sick. For a 13-hour flight, you don't want to have that experience, especially if you're flying solo. Ah. No, no, no. Tip number three. What? Always moisturize your face. Of course, every time I wash my face and go to the shower, I make it a point that I always moisturize my face. And if your crush sees you with a dry face, it's a no, no, no. Whenever that happens, when I see my crush, I make sure that my face is moisturized. And I bring this tiny container with me so that I can easily dab, dab, dab. Anytime, anywhere, your skin looks young and fresh. Fresh like a mother. Tip number four. I always pray to God that the person seated right next to me is quiet, doesn't snore, doesn't have any body odor. But you know, I'm so lucky, every time I travel long haul flights, I always get the stinky seatmate. So I make sure that I have my inhaler with me. Tip number five.
Now watch me whip, kill it. Now watch me nae nae. Okay. Now watch me whip, whip, watch me nae nae. Why me
do? Most of the time I don't use my eye contacts when I travel because my eyes get so dry.
Oh,
Tip number 6. I bring my sleeping mask with me. You will sleep better with eye mask, you know? And it's just like you will sleep better. I guarantee. Tip number 7. It can get really, really dirty. Super dirty. Extra dirty inside the aircraft, of course, because you are literally inhaling each other's breath. And whenever I use the public toilet, it can get nasty. Even after I wash my hands, I always make sure that I bring my hand sanitizer. Because some people, they don't like washing their hands. Will you die if you wash your hands? Some of you might think I'm a germ freak, but no, I'm trying to avoid myself from getting sick, especially when I travel. Tip number 8. I always bring snacks because your girl is always hungry. Sometimes a span of like lunch till dinner or dinner till breakfast can go about like 6-7 hours. So I make sure your girl is never hungry. Tip number 9. These long-haul flights can get your back really strained. Especially if you don't have that much leg room. I make sure that I walk from time to time. Walk it like it's okay. Walk it like it's okay. Ay, walk it like it's okay. Walk it like it's okay.
Go on a little stretch.
It's also not good for your back to be seated for a long time. Tip number 10. Abir tayo, sumakit ang ulo ko, sumakit ang bewang ko. Six months. Whenever I travel, I make sure that I wear sweaters or shirt, just basic clothing. It can get super cold inside the aircraft, so I make sure that I bring my hoodie and I'm comfortable. You know, pants, sneakers, or shorts, one backpack. But since I'm here in Europe during winter time, my stuff can get super packed easily because of the winter clothes. So thick that it takes so much of your luggage space. That's why I needed to have another carry-on, roll-on. It's also annoying if you have a layover and you have so much stuff with you. Being smart about the things that you bring can save you a lot of energy, a lot of time, especially if you have to scan your stuff. Tip number 11. Last but not the least, I just discovered this app called Audible. I've been using it for about a month now. I logged into www.audible.com/avalovinit. Also, for my viewers in the USA, you can text avalovinit to 500 to get your 30-day free trial. And with that free trial, I got one audiobook and two Audible originals for free. As for me, I downloaded the book Becoming Supernatural by Dr. Joe Dispenza. Oh my gosh, you guys need to read this. Audible content has an unmatched selection of audiobooks from comedy, news, business, travel, literature, theater, everything that interests you, it's all in Audible app. You can search it per category and it's pretty easy to use. Downloading the Audible app is for free, whether it's for iPhone, iPad, smartphone, tablets. Also, the good thing about it is that once you purchase the book, you have it lifetime. I've been listening to it without even Wi-Fi. That's why I'm super happy because I can do something while I'm inside the plane and someone's actually narrating it to me, which for me is easier. Also, when I'm inside the car, I tend to get nauseated when I read. So audiobook just helps me out with these kind of situations. Unlike your ex, your audiobook won't leave you ever. It's stuck with you for a lifetime. And you can access your books anytime, anywhere, wherever you like, as long as you have your phone. Whether you're traveling, doing the chores, cooking, when you're inside the shower, when you're driving, when you're walking your dogs, when you're with your friends that you don't want to talk to, And in case your phone gets lost or stolen, you can always download Audible and log into your account. You still have your books for a lifetime. Like I said, it won't leave you forever and ever. Even if you know you're single, at least you have your audiobooks. Never gonna leave your side. Even if you break up with your membership, you still get to keep the book. Once again, make sure to log on to www.audible.com/avalovinit or send avalovinit to 500 500 if you're from the USA to get your 30-day free trial from Audible. I guess this ends my vlog. If you like this video, make sure to give it a big thumbs up. If you're not yet subscribed, you know the drill. Tell your friends, tell your family, tell your neighbors about Avalovinit and subscribe. Don't skip the ad. And I'll see you guys on the next vlog. Bye!